All right, let's go through the special cards and teach you just as a refresher for us. If you remember, there are four special cards along with the regular deck. There is a one, there's a dog, there's a phoenix, and there's a dragon. I just took four kind of wild cards or jokers that were in the deck and just colored them around so to make them kind of fun. So let's go over each one. The one. If you get the one in your hand and you have that after everybody's passed their three cards, you have to pass them face down. You can't look at your cards, by the way, those three cards that are passed to you until after you've passed your three cards. But let's say you get the one. That is the card for the person that begins play. It's different than most games where if I dealt, this person would then go first. It doesn't matter. If I got the one, it doesn't even matter that I dealt. I get to go first. And I simply just say, I have the one. So whoever has it, when the cards have all been passed and you're ready to start the game, the person who has the one says, I have the one. Now, I can play this one in a couple of ways. I can play it as a single card, and of course, a two or higher would beat that. I can, and by the way, I don't even have to play the one if it is my turn. It just means I can lead. If I have a straight or I have some kind of full house or whatever else I want to play, I can play it. I don't have to play the one. But it's good to play it pretty early in the game because it's very hard, difficult to get rid of later on in the game. It's the lowest card. So even if somebody puts down a two, you still can't play this card to beat that two. So I could play this as a single card, as I said. I could also play it in a straight. A one, two, three, four, five, or higher, five or more cards straight, five, six, seven, eight, nine, whatever. I could play it like that. I could also play it as a pair, even though there's not another one, and we'll get to this in a second. A phoenix is a wild card. I actually could play the one and the phoenix together and say that's a pair of ones. I don't know. There's maybe a certain time where maybe you would do that, but that's at least an option. So that's the one. Now, there's also something else you can do with the one. Whenever the person who has the one does play the one, whether it's right off the bat or later on in the game, they can actually call a card. It can't be any of the special cards, but they can call a two through an ace. And if it's let's say I call an eight, that means the next person who can play an eight has to play an eight. If this person over here has an eight, even if they have four eights, if they have three eights, and they're wanting to use it for, or they have something in a straight, they don't want to play the eight, they have to play it. So that person would then have to play the eight. Now, that person could say, if they don't have any eights, they would say, I don't have an eight, and then they could play whatever they wanted. If they played a two or three or four, five, six, or seven, then this person has to play an eight, my partner. And if they don't have an eight, then this person would have to play an eight. It's whoever, and if they don't, I have to play an eight. It's whoever can play an eight the next possible opportunity they have to play it. Now, here's what's interesting. If this person says, I don't have an eight, and plays a nine or higher, well, this person could have an eight, but they can't play it because they can't play an eight on top of a nine. So maybe they'll pass, or maybe they play something else like a king. And this person then plays, an ace. This person has an eight as well, but they can't play it. Can't play it on top of a king. They play like an ace. Everybody passes. This person then gets the trick. Now, the rule is still the same. Even though the trick is over, whoever can play an eight first has to play an eight. So this person over here, if they have an eight, they won the trick, they would have to play an eight or a combination that has an eight in it, but they have to play it. So it's whoever can play an eight first has to play the eight if I call an eight, or I can call whatever else I want to call. I can also choose just not to call a card. Sometimes it's risky to do that because you can actually mess up your partner if the person didn't have the card and it maybe takes a combination away from your partner. But you can do that. Whenever I have the one, I always try to remember what card I gave these two people so that I can go, oh, okay, I gave this person a five. I'll just call a five because I know they have at least, I know they at least have one five. So sometimes I'll do that. So that's the one. Then there's the dog. The dog is great for the partnership part of the game because once I win a trick, or anytime I do win a trick, instead of playing another combination from my hand, I can play the dog instead. So I have to have won a trick, or maybe it's my first play of the game. I have the one. I can actually play the dog if I want to because it's my lead. But whenever you have the lead, you can play your combination, whatever it is, a single card, a pair, three of a kind, the full house, the straight. Or two or more consecutive pairs, whatever it is, or I can play the dog instead. If I play the dog, I just hand it over to my partner, and now it's my partner's turn. They would just turn it over, put it on their tricks that they won, and they now would lead. I usually play a dog when I'm pretty sure I don't have any more cards or any higher cards that I think maybe I can continue to win. You don't want to be stuck with the dog, because you can't get rid of it. If you can't win a trick, you can never play the dog. Now, if I play the dog later on in the hand, my partner's already run out of cards, let's say. And so now it's just us three players, because by the way, when you run out of cards, the game doesn't end. It ends when it goes down to the last player who has cards. So my partner's out. Then it goes to that person. They're out. It then goes to the next person in the rotation, which would be right over here at this person. Now, let's say they're out, and it's just me and this person playing left in the game. I could play the dog. It go to my partner. They're out. It goes to this person. They're out. It comes right back to me. It's my turn again. So that's how the dog is played. Then you have the Phoenix. Phoenix is a wild card. It can be played with anything else, and it can act as a 2 through an ace. It can't be, we're going to talk about the dragon, it can't be another dragon or anything like that, or any of these special cards, but it can be a 2 through an ace. I can play it as something maybe with a 5 to make a pair of 5s. Maybe I have 2 5s. I can make it 3 5s. Now, I can't make a 3 of a kind into a 4 of a kind, so remember that. Remember, a 4 of a kind is a bomb. You cannot make a bomb with the Phoenix. So just keep that in mind. Bombs have to be just straight up natural cards. So you can't put this with 5, 6, 7, 8 of diamonds and make this some kind of straight flush. You can't do that. You can't put it with 3 5s and make it 4 5s. So that's one thing you have to keep in mind. But other than that, you can put it with any other combination to make any of the straights a little bit longer, to fill out a straight, to make a 3 of a kind, to make a full house, whatever you want to do. That's a Phoenix. It can also be played as a single card. And when it's played as a single card, it is whatever card before it plus 1/2. So if I play it on a queen, it becomes a queen and a half. That means the next person has to play a king to beat it. So it becomes whatever the card it is plus a half, which means if you play it on an ace, it's an ace and a half. Very difficult to beat. Now, there is one card that can beat it, the dragon. We'll talk about that in a second. But that's a great time to play it as a single card because there's only one other card in the deck that could beat that. Now, a Phoenix can't go a dragon and a half. We'll talk about that in a second. It can only be played on the regular cards. So, but it could make the highest single card it would be an ace and a half if it's played on top of an ace. So that's the Phoenix. Then you have the dragon. The dragon is the highest single card in the deck. It can only be played as a single card. That means if an ace is played, a dragon always beats an ace. Nothing beats a dragon. If a Phoenix is played, that's an ace and a half. A dragon beats that. So there's only one thing that can beat a dragon, and that's a bomb. So you can put down 4 2s or 4 whatever on it. But that's the only thing that can beat a dragon. Is a bomb. So that's the highest single card. Now it's interesting, when you win a trick with the dragon, let's say I won this trick, every other time I keep my trick and I keep those and I count up those points after the game. With a dragon, you actually have to give the trick to one of the players that is not your partner who you think might go out last. The reason I say that is because the dragon is worth quite a bit of points, but you could get the points back for your team if the person does go out last and you or your teammate goes out first. So I would give it to one of the players and just lay it down in front of them. It's now their trick. Now, even though it's their trick, it's still my lead. It's not their turn. I won the trick, but I have to give it away, and it's my lead. Now, if it's bombed, let's say there's somebody who bombs that, then I don't give that trick away because it didn't win with the dragon. Only the trick that wins with the dragon has to be given away. Hopefully that makes sense. So those are the four four special cards for Teachu. So remember that as you play the game, and it makes the game super, super exciting and pretty unpredictable at times. So it's fun.